Hi everyone, this is Panos from NetBiz, and welcome to another Facebook Live demo. Today we'll be talking about TCP versus QUIC. So I don't know if you know how many of you know about TCP and QUIC, but QUIC is a new transport protocol. TCP, of course, is well known, is 44 years old. And honestly, it works pretty well. And the whole internet runs on TCP, right? However, Google saw that there was room for improvement. And in 2012, they started developing QUIC, which stands for QUIC UDP Internet Connections. In 2014, they started deployment on different Google products. And of course, the reason for Google to start working on a new transport protocol was performance. Google knows very well its business, and it knows that every millisecond counts when it comes to user experience and how long somebody stays on any of their products, YouTube, email, when they serve ads or search results. So let's see now how UDP and TCP differ. So QUIC sits on top of UDP and actually includes the encryption part. For a TCP stack, the traditional TCP stack, the TLS encryption is a different part of the stack, right? QUIC now sits on top of UDP and includes the encryption part. And of course, it handles all the logic to establish a reliable connection between a client and the server. Because of course, UDP is connectionless and cannot offer that natively. So what's the difference here? Where does the performance improvement come in QUIC? So TCP, you know well how TCP works and how the handshake process works, right? So TCP requires typically a three-way handshake to establish a connection. And on top of that, they have to add all the communication again between the client and the server for the TLS or any encryption you are using. So now QUIC gets rid of that. So QUIC is built on UDP. So it requires just one packet to establish a connection, and that includes also the TLS part of this communication. And actually, if the client and the server have already spoken in the past, then they may not need any handshake to establish communication. Actually, by Google's measurements, that happens in 75% of the time. So you have already used, let's say, if your browser has already talked to Google server today or in the past, let's say 1 month, that when a new connection starts, your browser, most likely Chrome, that uses QUIC, is gonna establish the connection without any handshake. Another major part of the improvement performance comes for multiplexing. So the communication between the client and the server is multiplexed, and this overcomes the head-of-line blocking issues that are common with TCP connections. And of course, there are some other improvements as well, like improved congestion control and forward error connection. So all these make QUIC faster and performs better than the typical TCP stack. But let's see how much is that. So of course, Google is the main driver of QUIC and the major user of QUIC at this point. And according to their measurements, with QUIC, they have managed to reduce YouTube video rebuffering from 15 to 18%, and Google search latency between 3.6 and 8%. So, and this may not seem like very high numbers, but you have to consider that TCP communication on Google servers and applications have been highly optimized, you know, by hundreds or maybe thousands of engineers over these years. So even moving the needle even by a few percentage points is very significant. And on top of that, you have to consider that these improvements now are on 35% of Google's egress traffic, okay, which corresponds to almost 10% of the whole internet traffic, right? So now having these improvements on these billions of connections every day adds up a lot, right? So it's a big improvement, actually. So Right now, if you're using any of Google products, most likely you are using QUIC instead of TCP. You don't know that, of course, because it's transparent to you. And the good thing with QUIC is that it also is building the application layer. So Chrome, for example, itself has QUIC built in it and doesn't rely on the operating system TCP network stack, right? And that is makes easy to, let's say, install newer QUIC versions. Otherwise, you would have to really, update your operating system if you were to do any improvements in the TCP communication stack. So if you're on Chrome right now, there's 88% chance that your traffic goes to Google servers over QUIC. And it's not 100% because there are cases, for example, in mainly like corporate environments where outbound UDP traffic might be blocked. And in that case, of course, when Chrome detects that, it falls back to TCP. So there are cases that Chrome or other products are not able to use QUIC and they fall back to TCP. So QUIC is better than TCP overall, it looks like. So it's here to stay. And since it's backed by Google, it looks like we're going to be hearing a lot more about QUIC in the future, and maybe at some point we'll see actually QUIC being part of the operating system stack as communication protocol. So it remains to be seen though when other companies will start adopting QUIC. I guess when it becomes part of the operating system stack, then it's going to be inevitable. But there's a committee right now working on a standard and everything, so it looks like they're going towards that direction. That's it for today. QUIC, a very interesting subject to look up. Actually, you can look it up on Google and find tons of material that Google has openly presented at different conferences and have shared with the world. Thank you all. Bye. Have a nice weekend.